wouldn't be on your program tonight, Andrew, if we didn't carry out that stunt yesterday. And I was in with our right.
No, but I'm not going to let. I'm here to tell you.
Father Rod Bowers, can you just let me finish, mate? You invited me on your program, and all you want to do is just critique me.
Hello, I'm Paul Barry. Welcome to Media Watch. And that was Nick Foulkes, leader of the anti-Muslim Party for Freedom, being given a grilling by Sky's Andrew Bolt. Foulkes has long been keen to get into the media spotlight, and he did it in spectacular fashion last week when he and his band of followers, dressed as cartoon Muslims, arrived at a New South Wales church for Sunday service. And if you missed the media stunt, well, it went something like this.
An extreme group of Pauline Hanson supporters has pulled a dramatic and terrifying stunt, storming an Anglican church on the Central Coast, renowned for supporting Muslims and embracing multiculturalism.
10 burly men in burkas burst into the Sunday morning service at Gosford Anglican Church.
We're here to tell you this is the future.
An intrusion designed to strike fear into the hearts of worshippers.
The intrusion was also designed to produce headlines, and so it did, here in Australia and overseas. In Israel, Turkey, China, Indonesia, and around the world on Britain's BBC. And here in Australia, Foulkes was rewarded with at least 5 radio and TV interviews, including one on Tens the Project with Waleed Ali.
You find what offensive, the idea that we would accept refugees who happen to be Muslim, Nick? Is that...
No,
is
yeah,
that
well, absolutely, Waleed. I think that, you know, Australia's been very generous over the years and, you know, it's time to say no. We've got to concentrate on issues within Australia.
Foulkes' pantomime act also scored him an interview with Fran Kelly on ABC RN Breakfast and on 7 News. And it produced this golden moment with the one-time king of radio, John Laws.
How old are you, Nick?
I'm 47, mate.
Jesus, you're old enough to know better. I mean, you're dressed up as a Muslim. How childish is that?
In each of these interviews, Foulkes was challenged, but also given a chance to respond. But then he met his match with Andrew Bolt, who told him he was rude, had discredited Pauline Hanson, and then terminated the interview.
This is not the ABC. This is not the ABC. When you do something that I consider wrong, offensive, trampling on people's rights, you don't get to spruik your cause. You've discredited your cause.
Just because
you've embarrassed yourself. You've
carried on in such a way.
The interview is over. Goodbye.
That dismissal prompted Father Rod Bower, the Anglican priest and refugee advocate whose church was stormed, to tweet cheekily,
"You know your career as a right-wing extremist is over when Andrew Bolt cuts you off. Priceless."
So why would Andrew Bolt, champion of the right to offend, want to muzzle his guest, some of whose views on Muslim immigration and multiculturalism he surely shares? Bolt answered that question himself next day.
Some people yesterday didn't get. I said, you're in favour of free speech. How come you cut off that guy from this far-right organisation? And listen, he's free to speak, but I can choose whether or not to promote his message. I choose not to. He can speak somewhere else. It's not a free speech issue at all.
Which makes you wonder why Bolt invited Foulkes on in the first place. Because even in shutting him down, he gave the Party for Freedom yet more publicity, which is just what they wanted.